Welcome students in online class for the subject physics. Today we learn about chapter number 1, units and measurement. In this chapter we have studied dimensions and dimensional analysis. So first of all, we have seen what is meant by dimension. Dimension of physical quantity. A physical quantity are the powers to which the fundamental units must be raised to obtain unit of physical quantity. Called as dimension, means dimension of physical quantity are the powers to which fundamental units must be raised to obtain unit of fundamental quantity. So, dimensions of fundamental quantity like length, mass, time, electric current, luminous intensity, temperature, and amount of substance. These fundamental quantities can be represented or denoted like length is denoted by capital L, mass is denoted by capital M, time is denoted by capital T, electric current is denoted by capital I, luminous intensity is denoted by C, temperature is denoted by capital K, and mole of substance or amount of substance is denoted by mole. But dimensions in derived quantity quantities are written in product or quotient. Product or quotient of fundamental quantities. Which raised So, appropriate powers using a formula or equation of derived unit. Means there are some rules for writing dimensions. Rules for writing a dimensions of physical quantity. See here some rules. So first of all, we have seen number one rule is, from this discussion we see the rules for writing dimensions. So dimension of physical quantity is expressed in terms of fundamental quantities or fundamental units only, like mass, capital M, length, capital L, time is capital T. Second thing will be dimensions of physical quantity is expressed only in square bracket. Like this. Third will be if a physical quantity is expressed in denominator for writing the dimensions, the fundamental unit is raised to its power negative, like frequency. The formula for frequency will be reciprocal of time. So this time is fundamental unit is raised, so dimension will be is mass is absent, length is absent, so L raised to 0, M raised to 0, time is present in denominator, its power will be raised as negative. Fourth rule, it will be for writing dimension. For writing dimensions of physical quantities, if fundamental unit is absent, then the power is written as 0. Its power will be written as 0. Example, we know velocity, dimension. Dimensional formula for velocity will be distance divided by time. So, dimensions of velocity is square bracket. Here distance means length is present. So, L to the power 1. But mass is absent. If any fundamental unit which is absent, then we can take it as its power will be m raised to 0. And time is present in denominator. So, its power is raised as negative. That is the dimension for velocity. Fifth rule, any constants like K, any constants or any alphabet or any number has no dimensions. Has no dimensions. The sixth rule will be when dimensions of physical quantity in terms of fundamental units, in terms of fundamental units is written, then there is comma or full stop or exclamatory symbol or question mark is not written or is not right for writing the dimensions. These are the rules for writing the dimensions. These rules, when we follow, then using these rules we can determine the dimensions. So using rules of dimensions. Find the dimensions of following. Find the dimensions of following physical quantities. Number one, pressure, and number two, power. Here we can solve in two methods, that is dimensional formula for pressure is force divided by area, which is force is derived quantity, area is also derived quantity, so we can written as mass multiplied by acceleration for force, and here for area length multiplied by breadth. Here length is also measured, or breadth is also measured as length, so we written as mass upon length square multiplied by the derived unit of acceleration. Its formula will be velocity divided by time. So here time is fundamental unit, so we write mass divided by length square multiplied by time. But velocity is derived quantity having derived unit, so we can use the formula for velocity will be distance divided by time. But here distance is measured as length, so one length must be cancelled. So the dimensional formula will be mass divided by length multiplied by time square. So dimension of pressure is square bracket L raised to minus 1, M raised to 1, T raised to minus 2, square bracket complete. That is the dimension for pressure. Similarly, we can solve dimensions for power. So we know power is to do work, means work divided by time. That is the dimensional formula for power. So we know that time is fundamental unit or fundamental quantity, but work is derived unit. So work is written as force multiplied by distance. That is dimensional formula for work divided by time. See here, distance and time, they are fundamental units, but force is derived. So we can write distance upon time multiplied by mass multiplied by acceleration. So here we can write as distance multiplied by mass divided by time. So acceleration is derived unit, so it can be represented as dimensional formula for acceleration will be velocity upon time. So here time is also fundamental unit, so we can write distance multiplied by mass divided by time square multiplied by, again here velocity, its formula will be distance upon time. See here, if we write, so it becomes distance square multiplied by mass divided by time cube. So dimension for power is square bracket L raised to 2, M raised to 1, T raised to minus 3. So we can find out dimensions for pressure and for power. Similarly, we can also find out to find dimensions of electric potential and electric and resistance. If we can find out electric potential and resistance, so here we can solve. For electric potential, dimensional formula will be work upon charge, and for resistance formula will be electric potential divided by electric current. Okay, see here we know charge is derived quantity, but current is equal to charge upon time. So charge is equal to current multiplied by time. So here electric potential is equal to force multiplied by distance divided by current multiplied by time. So distance, current and time, they are fundamental units. So we can write distance upon current multiplied by time multiplied by force will be mass multiplied by acceleration. So here we can write as distance multiplied by mass divided by current multiplied by time multiplied by, here acceleration will be derived quantity. So acceleration is velocity divided by time. Again, we see distance multiplied by mass divided by current multiplied by time square. multiplied by velocity means its formula will be distance upon time. So here if we write distance square multiplied by mass divided by current multiplied by time square. So dimension for electric potential is, we can write square bracket L raised to 2, M raised to 1, T raised to cube, because T square and time. Here T raised to cube means T to the power minus 3 and I to the power minus 1. This is dimension for electric potential. So here if we can find out resistance, dimension for resistance, its dimensional formula will be electric potential divided by electric current. So here we can take an as square bracket L raised to 2, M raised to 1, T raised to minus 3, I raised to minus 1 divided by electric current, that is L raised to 0, M raised to 0, T raised to 0, I raised to 1. If I raised to 1 is taken in numerator, so here dimensions of resistance is square bracket L raised to 2, M raised to 1, T raised to minus 3, I raised to minus 2, because 1 in numerator minus 1, minus 1 and minus 1 becomes minus 2. This is the dimensions for resistance. So here we can see the dimensional analysis. Dimensionals analysis. So here in this dimensional analysis, first of all, we know that a physical equation must be dimensional constant. Or is called principle of dimensional homogeneity. Dimensional homogeneity or dimensional analysis. See here, dimensional analysis is a method It is a method which analyzes dimensions of physical quantities. Dimensions of physical quantities. Number one, its uses is, uses of dimensional analysis is to check the equation whether it is correct or not. The first dimensional analysis use will be to check the equation whether it is correct or not. Number two, second use will be to perform the relation, perform the relation between, to perform the relation between two physical quantities. Two physical quantities. And the third use of dimensional analysis will be to determine or to find the conversion factor between units of physical quantity in two different systems like MKS or CGS or FPS systems. So these are the uses for dimensional analysis. Dimensional analysis is a physical equation must be a dimensional constant is called principle of dimensional homogeneity or is called dimensional analysis. So first of all, we can use the using dimensional analysis. Using the dimensional analysis, show that the following physical equation or dimensional equation is correct or not. The given equation is S is equal to UT plus half AT square. So here, if we can solve by using dimensional analysis, so here we can take left hand side of given equation is equal to S, which is called as displacement. S is called as displacement. So dimension of displacement is measured as length is square bracket L raised to 1, M raised to 0, T raised to 0. Suppose this is equation number 1 for LHS. Here for RHS, the given will be UT plus half AT square, where U is initial velocity and A is acceleration. So we can take it as UT or dimensions of UT is velocity multiplied by time, which is distance upon time multiplied by time. What happen? Time get cancelled. So we can take it as dimensions of UT will be square bracket L raised to 1, M raised to 0, T raised to 0. This is equation A. And another term is dimensions of half AT square. If we solve dimensions of half AT square, it will be half multiplied by acceleration multiplied by time square. Here half is pure number, has no dimension, so we can take as velocity. Its dimensional formula will be velocity upon time multiplied by time square. What happened? Time get cancelled. One time get cancelled. So velocity into time, which can taken as distance divided by time multiplied by time. So what happened? Time get cancelled. So dimensions for half AT square is square bracket L raised to 1, M raised to 0, T raised to 0. Equation B. So from A and B, RHS is equal to square bracket L1, M raised to 0, T raised to 0 plus L raised to 1, M raised to 0, T raised to 0, which is L raised to 1, M raised to 0, T raised to 0. Means these are the dimension for right hand side. So this is equation 2. From equation 1 and 2, we say that RHS is equal to LHS. So equation is correct dimensionally. Dimensionally, we prove that equation is correct. Second thing, second use of dimension will be convert unit of Newton into dyne. or show that one newton equal to 10^5 dyne. Show that one newton is equal to 10^-10^5 dyne. So here we can solve newton and dyne are units of force. Newton is unit of force in MKS systems, and dyne is unit of force in CGS system. So we show that we have write force in MKS is equal to K times force in CGS system. So dimension for force is mass multiplied by acceleration, which is mass multiplied by velocity divided by time. So it can be written as mass upon time multiplied by velocity, means distance upon time. So SI or dimensions for force or dimensions of force is square bracket L raised to 1, M raised to 1, T raised to minus 2. So here L raised to 1, M raised to 1, T raised to minus 2 in MKS is equal to K times L raised to 1, M raised to 1, T raised to minus 2 CGS. Means we can take as K equal to square bracket L raised to 1, M raised to 1, T raised to minus 2 MKS divided by square bracket L raised to 1, M raised to 1, T raised to minus 2 CGS, which is written as in MKS length is measured in meter multiplied by kilogram multiplied by second raised to minus 2 divided by, in CGS system, centimeter multiplied by gram multiplied by second raised to minus 2. What happened? Second raised to minus 2 get cancel. So here we can write meter, that is 100 centimeter upon 1 centimeter multiplied by kilogram, that is 1000 gram, means 1 kilogram divided by gram. So what happened? Centimeter centimeter get cancel, gram gram get cancel. So count the zero, it will be 10^5. So conversion factor will be 10^5. So if we can write, so newton or 1 न्यूटन इज इक्वल टू 10 टू द पावर 5 डाइन. सो विच कैन बी प्रूव. दिस कैन बी प्रूव. सो हियर द थर्ड डायमेंशनल यूज विल बी रिलेशन. गिव्स द रिलेशन. सो हियर the atmospheric pressure, taken as P. Atmospheric pressure P of the gas, comma height of mercury column is h and acceleration due to gravity is small g. If density of mercury is rho, using dimensional analysis, derive a dimensional formula for atmospheric pressure P. If such question is there, then we can solve the third use of dimensional analysis to make the relation between two physical or three physical quantities. Here, dimensional analysis is used to suggest formula by assuming powers or power relation. Let us see. Atmospheric pressure P is proportional to xth power of density rho, comma yth power of height and zth power of acceleration due to gravity. See here, पी प्रोपोर्शनल टू रो टू द पावर एक्स एच टू द पावर वाई एंड स्मॉल जी टू द पावर जेड मीन्स पी इज इक्वल टू के रो टू द पावर एक्स एच टू द पावर वाई एंड जी टू द पावर जेड वेयर k is dimensionless constant. We know dimensions of power. So, power is equal to, dimensions of pressure. Pressure is equal to force upon area. Pressure is equal to force upon area means mass multiplied by acceleration divided by length multiplied by breadth. So, dimension can found by pressure will be mass divided by length square multiplied by velocity divided by time because acceleration is derived unit. Acceleration will be derived unit. So, here we can write mass divided by length square multiplied by distance upon time multiplied by time. What happened? One distance get cancelled and remaining will be the pressure dimensional formula. Dimensional formula for pressure is mass divided by length multiplied by distance. Multiplied by time square. So, dimension will be m l raised to minus 1, m raised to 1, t raised to minus 2. Suppose this is dimensional formula for pressure, atmospheric pressure will be equation A. Here we can find out dimensions for of density is rho is equal to mass upon volume is equal to mass upon length multiplied by breadth. So multiplied by height. Breadth and height is measured as length. So we can write mass divided by length cube. So dimension of rho is square bracket L raised to minus 3, M raised to 1, T raised to 0. Equation B. Again, we can find out height. Dimensions of height is L raised to 1, M raised to 0, T raised to 0. That is equation C. And lastly, dimensions of acceleration due to gravity. So we know that acceleration due to gravity, its dimensional formula will be velocity upon time, which is distance upon time multiplied by time. So dimensions of acceleration due to gravity is square bracket L raised to 1 M raised to 0 T raised to minus 2 equation D. Using equation A, B, C and D, these four equations we can written as, so dimension of pressure is L raised to minus 1 M raised to 1 T raised to minus 2, which is equal to dimension of density will be L raised to minus 3 M raised to 1 T raised to 0 to the power x. Dimension of height will be L raised to 1 M raised to 0 T raised to 0 to the power y. And dimension of acceleration due to gravity, it will be L raised to 1 M raised to 0 T raised to minus 2, its power will be z. So by solving L raised to 1 M raised to 1 L raised to minus 1 M raised to 1 T raised to minus 2 is equal to L raised to minus 3x M raised to x T raised to 0, again L raised to y M raised to 0 T raised to 0, again L raised to z M raised to 0 and T raised to minus 2 z. Okay, see here, rearranging the term, that will be L raised to minus 1 M raised to 1 T raised to minus 2 is equal to L raised to minus 3x plus y plus z M raised to x and T raised to minus 2 z. If we can see, so from above equation, from this equation we compare, then minus 3x plus y plus z is equal to minus 1, comma x is equal to 1 and minus 2z is equal to minus 2. Here minus 2 minus 2 becomes plus, so z is equal to 1, x is equal to 1. So the equation will be minus 3 multiplied by 1 plus y plus z having value 1 is equal to minus 1. What happened? Minus 3 plus y plus 1 is equal to minus 1. Plus 1 and minus 3 will be minus 2 is equal to minus 1. Y minus 2 is equal to minus 1. Therefore, y is equal to 2 minus 1, which is 1. Means x is 1, y is 1 and z is 1. So atmospheric pressure, P is equal to rho hg. this is the atmospheric pressure. Or if we can take K, so K is constant for dimension and that is taken as 1, so atmospheric pressure is equal to rho hg. For your more practice, assignment is given. Using this assignment, you can solve the questions.